Dear students, how are you? I am Jahangir Alam Tipu, senior teacher of Kumila Modern High School of English. I have come to you with another grammar class, and it is about right form of verbs. In my previous class, I have showed you how right form of verbs are used in gaps. Okay, now I am going to describe it in details. Right form of verbs. Before that, you should know how many kinds of verbs are there in English. In English, there are two kinds of verbs. One is finite verb, and the other is non-finite verb. Okay. Actually, these finite verbs and non-finite verbs are used in filling gaps. Dear students, I am going to discuss about right form of verbs. Right form. What do you mean by form? Okay. Form. Form means shape. Design, etc. In verbs there are various kinds of forms. Like, I am going to write first one is root form, that means base form. We can say this is present form. Past form. Past participle form, ing form, negative form, and passive form. These are the forms of a verb. If I give an example, you can clearly understand. Suppose for one, write. Write. Write means likha. This is the right base form or root form or present form. Write, put, read, walk, run. These are the present form. these are the base form and these are the what? Root form. Now for right, the first form of right is wrote. Okay, the past participle form of right is written. The ing form is just add ing with the base form. Negative form, that means auxiliary verb plus not plus verb. Passive form, to be plus PP. That means to be verb plus the past participle of any kind of verb. These are passive form. Okay, dear students, I know you face a trouble to put these correct forms in the gaps because you are given a passage with some gaps for using verbs in right forms. Then you cannot use right form or correct form of the verb. Okay, actually why you cannot use these forms in the gaps? Actually it depends on subject matter, it depends on subject, that means agreement with the subject. There is a an agreement with the subject, and also it depends on tense, it depends on person and number. If you use, if you understand the subject matter, then you will be able to use either it is past form or it is present form. And after that, you should know that if you are going to use a verb, you must know there is an agreement with the verb. Okay, and I am going to give an example. Suppose patriotism dash a noble pursue, it dash a man to shed the last drop of blood to dash his country. Now students, like this is a passage. Number A, number B, number C. Now students, can you tell me what type of passage is this? This is a passage which describes something. The subject matter is patriotism, right? So if anything describes something, the passage will be in the present form. But sometimes we see there are past events in the passage, and this is actually we can see in the story. like this. Nina, Mitu, Razu, Dash, a mango, Mina, Dash of the tree, she, Dash the mango and dash it to Raju. Dear students, this is a story. This is a story because you can see here are some characters. If any characters are present in a passage, then this is a story, and in most cases the stories are in the past form. So if you use verbs in these gaps, number A, number B, number C, number D, then you have to make past form of the verbs, right? You have to make past form of the verbs for this passage, and for this passage you have to make the present form of the verbs, right? Dear students, there are not only two forms, there are various forms I have showed you. Now in the first passage we can see the passage is about patriotism. Patriotism dash a noble person. You have to use here a verb for number A. B verb in the present tense. Patriotism, third person singular number. So is. Patriotism is a noble person. It dash a man to shed the last drop of blood. It dash a man. Inspire. It inspires, as this word is third person singular number. Then add S or ES with the word. Inspires a man to shed the last drop of blood to dash his country. To protect, to defend his country, or to protect his country. Okay, these are in the present form. But in number two, Mina, Mithu, Raju picked a mango, collected a mango in the past form. Mina climbed up the tree. Not climbed, but past form climbed. Mina climbed up the tree. She dashed the mango. She picked the mango and threw it to Raju. Threw it to Raju. These are the first forms. Okay. Dear students, you are facing some other problems. And I am going to show you what the problems are. Suppose a sentence is given here. We dash water in many ways. Use a verb, and the verb is use. Dear students, what will be the answer of number one? In number two, water dash in many ways. Okay, use also this word for number two. For number one, we dash water in many ways. Here the word is use. We use water for in many ways. আমরা পানি বিভিন্ন উপায়ে ব্যবহার করে থাকি করি ওয়াটার ড্যাশ ইন মেনি ওয়েজ ওয়াটার নাম্বার টু ওয়াটার ইজ ইউজড ইন মেনি ওয়েজ ইজ ইউজড ইন মেনি ওয়েজ হোয়াই দেয়ার ইজ এ ডিফারেন্স অ্যাকচুয়ালি দ্য ডিফারেন্স ইজ ফর সাবজেক্ট In number one, we can see the subject is we, but in number two, the subject is water. Okay, subject we for use for this verb. So, use the subject we for verb use direct. Direct action of the subject. The subject is doing the work. The subject is doing water. The subject is doing the work of using water in many ways. So, who is using? Who use? If the answer is subject, then the subject is doer. The subject is doer. There are two types of subjects here. One is doer subject. The other is non-doer subject. These two are the classes of subjects. Okay, doer subject and non-doer subject. Dear students, if you see the subject is doer subject, then only use tense. Okay, active sentence. Active subject, active verb. Okay, but if the subject is non-doer, like number two, water, it has no power to use. Okay, we use water. Water can be used. Water is used. Pani ke byabohar kora hoy. Pani nije byabohar korte pare na. Tahole ei khetre amra pani ki bolbo? Pani ekhane non-doer. Water ekhane non-doer. Ar amra byabohar kori. Just make a question for verb who, using who. The answer is subject, then it is doer. If you make a question with which or what, not who, then the question is, then the answer is water and then it is non-doer. Okay. অর্থাৎ আমি বাংলায় বলছি সাবজেক্ট যদি কাজটা করে থাকে কে দ্বারা প্রশ্ন করলে যদি সাবজেক্টটা পাওয়া যায় তাহলে সেই সাবজেক্টকে আমরা ডুয়ার সাবজেক্ট বলবো আর কে দ্বারা প্রশ্ন করলে যদি সাবজেক্ট না আসে কি বা কাকে বা কোনটাকে দ্বারা প্রশ্ন করব তখন যদি সাবজেক্টটা পাই তখন সেই সাবজেক্টকে বলবো আমরা নন ডুয়ার ওকে যদি এটা কেন বলছি Why? Doer and non-doer. if the subject is non-dual, then use passive form. Here passive form means to be plus PP. Okay, to be plus PP passive form. So what are is used in many ways? Is used, is to be verb, used the past participle of use. Used, is used, water is used, water can be used, water was used, water has been used. Okay, these are passive form. So, okay. Water is used in many ways. Water is polluted in many ways. Polluted in many ways. You can use pollute. Okay. Dear learners, now have a look on this next sentence, on the next sentence. Water dash in many ways makes our life miserable. Okay. In this sentence, you can see there are two verbs. One is this one and the other is this one. Okay. In a simple sentence or in a single clause, if you see there are two verbs or more than one verbs, now one verb will be in finite verb. And the other verb will be in non-finite verb. Or the other verbs will be in non-finite verbs. Okay. Finite verb, non-finite verb. Look at here. This verb has S. This verb shows present tense. For this reason, this verb is finite verb. But this verb will be then non-finite verb. Okay, non-finite verb. Now use pollute for this gap. How can you use this? If you say water is polluted in many ways makes our life miserable, this is a wrong sentence, because as there is a passive form with to be verb, this means auxiliary verb. If there is any kind of auxiliary verb before a verb, it is finite verb. And for this reason, is polluted is a finite verb. Now transform this finite verb into non-finite. Okay. As this is a passive, then just omit to be verb. From passive form, just omit to be verb. Only past participle form is non-finite verb. So, water In number here are two, number one, number two.
In number one,
water is polluted, is polluted. But in number two, water polluted.
Water polluted in many ways makes our life miserable. Finite verb. Okay? Okay.
Now, students,
for active verb,
we, number one, we dash water in many ways number two we dash water in many ways make our life miserable.
Make our life miserable. Now, students, as this word, these two words are doers. So use active verb. Right.
Active verb. Pollute. We pollute water in many ways.
Present tense.
We pollute water in many ways, make our life miserable. Can I use pollute? We pollute water in many ways, make our life miserable.
No.
Because the verb make is finite verb.
For this reason,
pollute will be in non-finite verb.
For active verb, use only ing. Add ing with an active verb, then it has transformed into non-finite verb. Right? Dear students, I hope you have understood how finite verbs and non-finite verbs are used in gap-filling activities of verbs. I hope this will be helpful for you, dear students. I have to say goodbye today. I'll come with another class about right form of verbs. So, goodbye today. Thank you.